forecast this afternoon.
Chief Meteorologist Tony Petracca is in the Weather Center. Hi there, Tony.
Hi, Brian and Kim. Happy to say we're going to keep things a little quiet for a few days, kind of a breather from precipitation and ice and snow and things like that. So very cold, though. Our temperatures, you know, the trend of, you know, running below average, that'll continue. In fact, a frigid night tonight, late at night and early tomorrow morning. Take a look outside. Still holding on to some sunshine. It's fairly ineffective. And, you know, the sun this time of year, actually the angle of the sun is getting higher. It actually is getting stronger, even though we're in February. And so its ability to warm the atmosphere up is increasing. But sometimes that is overpowered by very cold air coming out of Canada, so it kind of squashes any ability for the sun to warm things up. Bottom line, it's cold. It'll stay that way for the next couple of days. We take a look at that Narragansett under partly cloudy skies, temperatures in the upper 20s to low 30s. So our threat tracker tonight through Friday and Saturday, low-level green, will bump it up to yellow on Valentine's Sunday. I want to take apart Saturday. Now, if you have dinner plans, you're going to do the Valentine's dinner Saturday evening, go ahead, don't cancel anything. Any precipitation on Saturday night is actually after midnight, and especially at the Valentine's Sunday morning. I would call this unsettled weather rather than any kind of a major storm. I do anticipate, though, you know, a messy mixture, some snow, some sleet, even some rain, especially during the morning, and then trying to dry out later in the afternoon. I think a more important storm system, though, is still scheduled for on Tuesday. We'll show you that in a 7-day forecast. It's mainly clear, very quiet across New England right now. Some very light snow showers early this morning to our south is now well offshore. I want to show you the big picture. Most of our moisture from storms either comes off the Atlantic or the Gulf of Mexico. So this is our moisture source for precipitation of late. And we're tracking a system coming across the West Coast. As this dives across the southern tier, it'll pick up some of this moisture. The net result will be some messy weather for the second half of the weekend. So I want to jump ahead now to Saturday morning. Notice we're dry, but also take notice of this developing storm. Here we are Saturday evening, 9 o'clock. We're still dry, but watch late Saturday night, a mixture of some snow and sleet overspreading the area. On Sunday morning, the storm to our south. Right now, we're going to try to push this thing offshore by later Saturday afternoon. Things will try to dry out the second half of the day. All right, let's backtrack to now. We'll take you through the evening and overnight with these temperatures tumbling. Single digits north and west to about 10 to 15 degrees elsewhere. Very cold start tomorrow morning. Sunshine gets to work. Doesn't really help the temperature. Only upper 20s for daytime highs. And then your Friday evening, Friday night is dry and cold under a partly cloudy sky. So for tomorrow morning, starting off some spots in the upper single digits, but rising to about 26. That's it by noontime. And sunshine, it's fairly ineffective, but at least it's a dry day. No precipitation. Daytime highs only in the mid and upper 20s. Saturday is dry right up and through the midnight hour. And again, we take apart Valentine's Day Sunday, especially during the morning. Kind of a messy mixture of some wet snow, sleet, and some rain. So stay tuned on that. Temperatures in the lower 30s. We get a breather on Monday, and then watching with interest some stormy weather on Tuesday. That may be a messy mixture as well with a high temperature at 32, so a very active weather pattern.